Now, we are going to get into the final round. And I don't know what to call this topic other than topic. Is Pesto Mime right to go after Jackson? I don't know what else to call it. Is Jackson really in the wrong here? Or is Jackson being very reasonable and Pesto Mime is just kind of... So Pesto, I want you to air all about your problems with Jackson. And like, just tell us what's your issue with him. And what the chat needs to vote on is who's reasonable, right? Is Jackson being unreasonable or what's going on, right?
Reasonable.
Okay, shut, bro. Okay, so Pesto, what is your qualms with Jackson you wanted to get out? And this is going to be 5 minutes. This is going to be a five-minute debate.
It doesn't matter if Jackson has all the best sources on the news, all the best sources on what's happening. My issue with the way that Jackson was handling these discussions with these people, he went and he told them all these factoids, all these whatever, arguing for 15 minutes about whether a number on the vote was one or two. It's not relevant. What's relevant to people, what's going to make people wake up and understand and live differently and see the world positively and understand that they can change it instead of being a pessimistic lefty or righty, same difference. What's going to matter is if they have a vision of humanity that is different from the vision that's being taught to us.
Well, how does Jackson lack that? How does Jackson lack that? Like, explain. Just talk about Jackson.
Jackson doesn't explain anything.
What?
Jackson goes and he tells people what happened physically. Okay, what happened chronologically?
Don't the facts matter?
But he doesn't go in on people and he doesn't bring it. What Jackson said so many times through this thing. Oh, you know, there's a multiplicity of issues here. There's not. There's an issue. There's a central issue. There's a central way that the world operates. It's one physical universe that we live in. It belongs to people. It belongs to God. People are made in the image of God.
But
and people
what?
Don't understand that. When Jackson goes and he says, oh, well, he did this, he did that. That's like you're describing what your dog did or something. It's not understanding that people, when you go and explain to somebody what's wrong with the world, you need to explain to them why they are greater, what makes them greater, and how the future is going to look. If Jackson goes and tells people, oh, there's this, there's that, he doesn't tell people exactly what the future is going to look like.
But doesn't he dispel? He dispels the establishment narrative, so isn't he doing a good job?
He dispels establishment narratives, but he keeps on to the one establishment narrative, which is that you have to care.
Wait,
right?
Okay, Jackson, do you go ahead and respond to this guy?
I want to hear a little bit more.
You have
like
to
a tiny bit more.
The facts of the narrative. The main narrative is that we're arguing about these things, whether they're blah blah blah. We're not talking about more fundamental issues about the spirit of God that's inside people and why that's being what's it called pushed down.
So, Jackson, you can go ahead and respond.
I did it.
Listen, Pesto, I've never been as speechless as I am right now in a debate. The facts just aren't coming to my head right now. I have nothing to say. I guess we'll try to engage with this. You think that I'm not painting a big picture arc of what's really happening, but I'm instead too invested in the facts, correct?
You're invested in these facts. You're invested in telling people what's happening, where it's happening. But
so what happens? What happens when we're dealing with a bunch of liberals and leftists and rightoids that are like they're regurgitating these State Department talking points, say about Syria, or they're believing this bullshit about like an investigation into what actually happened on January 6th, but they're missing all of the key details that actually allow us to paint the broader picture of what's going on. Because obviously, right? If you know my political worldview, you know that I think that the FBI and the intelligence community is working directly against Donald Trump. But you have to back that up with substantive points. And that's something that you honestly, despite how funny you are in your content and stuff, you haven't been able to do once in any of the conversations we've put forward.
So Pesto, what he's saying is, it seems like you mostly rely on like big narratives, but you don't go into the nitty gritty of like the details, and the details matter. So what do you have to say to that?
What Jackson just said right here, I do go into the details. You listen back, you'll see that I went into the details on some things when I was the person to talk before Jackson. Whenever Jackson talks first, Jackson gets all the details out of the way, and then he just stops. And then if somebody challenges him, he goes back to those details and he says, no, these details are right. No, those details are wrong. Why are those details right? Versus the other ones. Because like some source said so? No, they're right because the higher truth reinforces them. When Jackson goes saying, oh, you take all these right things, you take all these things that you know are right somehow, you know all these things are right.
Your truth disagrees with me.
You have a multiplicity of factors, and you build them together to make a worldview and to make an idea of what the truth is. Truth comes first.
Do you have any disagreement with Jackson about anything in particular? Or?
Yes, I do have a disagreement. I have a disagreement with the way that he talks to these people. Because when he talks to these people, none of them go home and they think about it. They are all home because it's Twitch.
I'm just going to use an example right now because I do think it's important, right? When we're taught the whole reason why I even got on Twitch in the first place, because I was just like doing stuff on YouTube. The whole reason why I got on Twitch was because I wanted to debate people. And I thought that debating would be an effective way of actually winning people over to my ideology. So the first debate that I ever did was against, I don't know if you know him, he's a streamer named Vosh. And we were talking about Syria, right? And everyone knew my interpretation of what happened surrounding this debate about a chemical attack in Syria. And everyone knew what Vosh's opinion was going to be, right? But when push came to shove and we were talking about the facts of the matter, that's all that really, you know, stood to push down Vosh's flimsy arguments that he was bringing forward, his flimsy narrative that was bringing forward. And the higher powers did not agree with my facts, but my facts were so strong that they completely, you know, like pushed down every strongman he put forward. So I disagree with you that like facts aren't important or facts can't speak to people, because the overwhelming majority of people who saw that debate all agree I won.
I saw bits of that debate. I agree that you won. I think you misunderstood what I meant by higher power. I don't mean the president. I don't mean Mueller or the CIA or something, or even the Queen. I don't mean that. Those are very low powers. When I talk about the higher power, I talk about what is it that makes things true, and that, you know, that's God, right?
No.
So hold on. I have a question for this. Is kind of what the debate's about. Pesto, is it always correct to like knock on an open door and condemn people for maybe not doing things? Like, isn't it that you know?
I'm having a dialogue.
Right, but it seems like you're going after Jackson just because he's not talking about like philosophy and stuff. But isn't it always that we can have different contexts of like sometimes the facts matter and that you could talk about philosophy later? Like, do you have to always talk about it all at once?
I think it does matter, because otherwise people are just going to hear these facts. They're going to look into it. They're not really going to know the difference between one source of a number and another source of the number in a different newspaper. One says it was this many. One says it was this many. Who
right,
cares?
But,
you're going to pick whichever one you
okay,
are.
Okay, so the specific example that you were getting really frustrated over.
Right, Pesto, let him talk.
Things that were true to him.
Pesto, let him talk.
That meant Vaush's whole project, the whole vision that he
had. All right, Pesto, I got to mute you. I got to mute you. You got to let him talk.
So with any of the debates that I engage in, be it like Vosh, Syria, whatever, be it the January 6th stuff that seemed to have triggered you, I always begin by explaining like my overarching premise. You know, in the debate with Vosh, I said, I believe, you know, there was a cover up. We don't really know what happened. It was potentially not a chemical attack, whatever. In the January 6th thing, I made it abundantly clear that I said, you know, it was a It was a FBI or intelligence community orchestrated event. And obviously, this is a part of like the broader campaign to try and, you know, establish their dominance and increase the power of the security state and go against the people who are, you know, trying to challenge that. Then I go into the details that back that up. And my details, nor my overarching opinion I put forward at the start, differs really from what you said. I think I just focus more on the former and you focus more on the latter. I think fusing both together, though, is the only way that you can win people over. I mean, even that the wordy person that was in here that was disagreeing with me initially surrounding January 6th and was saying like, oh, my God, no, the FBI is going to investigate this stuff. When I presented the facts and the evidence about the unindicted co-conspirators, all that stuff, you then heard Wordy backtrack what they were saying and start to agree with me. So I think your form of argumentation, albeit funny and good content, I think it's actually insufficient in convincing average people to your side.
I want to ask you, this is rhetorical, so don't answer it right away because there's more context to it. How do you know that you know something? Do you think that people come into politics, people like Wordy or anyone, maybe even all the viewers probably, that people come in and decide to be political people because they want to be right and factual? Or do they come in because they have a feeling that they need to change society somehow because as human beings, the creative spark that's in them is being...
But Pesto, don't you also believe that a lot of...
Everything in their mind is trying to get out and they need to fix that somehow.
What I think, it's a good question. What I think is that there are a lot of people who engage heavily in politics, I'd assume like yourself in the way that I do as well, who do want to change the world. But I think the masses who just casually listen to people like me, which I don't know your work, but I would think that my work is like the content I produce is like very palatable for the average individual in this country. You know, like I have a bunch of kids I go to high school with who listen to my show, who like don't really follow politics and disagree with my politics, but then they'll occasionally listen in and be like, yo, like I actually disagree or I actually agreed with what you said. And I think it's in part because I do structure my arguments in a way that fuses both of those things together. I don't know. I obviously it's not going to resonate with everyone. Just as your form of argumentation isn't going to resonate with everyone, but I care about winning over the masses, and I care about you know, changing the hearts and minds of the people, at least of this country.
Well, guys, I got a nosebleed.
So the difference is, I think the difference is because I do like you more than probably any other communist, besides for a few. Besides from like people who I can list, because you're a positive person and you have a good outlook on your own life and you want to go and engage with society and be healthy and have these hobbies. But the difference is that all these people talking about how they want to win over people, they want optics to appeal to people and strategy to appeal to people. It's not really what people go into politics to reinforced to just hear something that's right, hear something that goes to them like on a very surface level. You can look it up, it's right. Or you go over and you see someone and they look like someone that you knew in high school and they're being normal and you like them,
Pesto,
and they're having
Pesto.
Good confident way of talking.
Pesto, don't a lot of people though really do believe the myth that the media is very factual still? And isn't Jackson doing important work showing that's not the case?
He's showing the media
like Pesto, do you think people take for granted too much that the media's like not factual and they tell lies? Don't you have to prove it continually over and over again so people could see?
I think people are born knowing that the media is lying to them, and I think that just through forcing themselves to watch media they start to believe it. Mm-hmm. Most people know that the media is lying to them.
Yeah, right. But they,
because it's blatantly obvious that the people who are on the media and looking at you and saying stuff, maybe
I don't know. So Pesto, are you saying
right? But it feels
so Pesto, are you saying what Julian Assange did didn't matter then?
No, I'm not saying what Julian Assange
was,
did.
Wasn't
didn't
it
matter.
Important that he showed like all this stuff they were lying about and covering up? Didn't it make an impact on a lot of people when they found out Bush lied about WMDs? Like, people don't automatically know this, you know?
And Peso, like, what I want to put in, I don't think, I don't know how much you know my content and stuff like that, but what I do want to say is, like, what I do is, like, I don't know. I feel like what I do is hopefully, and I do believe that aesthetic is important. Or what did you say? You said you think like style or aesthetic or something's not important?
No, that's not what I said.
What was the exact word you said? You didn't say aesthetic.
Objects aren't important.
What's that? What? I didn't hear
what
you.
I said was all these things, you can go and do them, and they make a better package.
But you said something like you didn't say aesthetic. You said something like that though. It wasn't style or.
You said what I said was I used the word optics. I said people optics. They try and say, oh, we should wave the American flag optics. Because it has optics, not because it has history.
So I think that optics are extremely important. Not as important as the facts. Sorry, one second.
They're both secondary to the truth.
Wait. Let me finish my point here. I think this is something maybe you'll agree with. I think optics are very important, actually, not as important as facts. I think the overall narrative is obviously important, but if you can't back it up with the facts, then it's somewhat, less meaningful. But you need to fuse all of these things together. And in the same way that, WikiLeaks was trying to get out this information to the mass media in the way that they did about any number of issues, right? War crimes, corruption in government, etc. What Haas does or what I do, I think we see it almost as like, and Haas focuses a lot more on like theory-based things, but at least when I report on the news and do multiple stories every time I go live, I'm trying to bring the news in a factual manner and debunking whatever the propaganda is being pushed at the moment in a palatable way. Through optics, you know, by appealing to specifically like young people of my generation and showing them that, the media, CNN, progressive media, whatever, it's all bullshit. And they need to look a little bit harder at the facts of whatever story they're looking at.
All right. And then what?
So,
and then if people, they go and they see the media's bullshit, they listen to Jackson's version of events instead. And then what?
Then it's over, dude.
You're not giving them an idea of what the future is going to look like, an idea of what them as people are supposed to be doing and what they can look forward to doing. You don't give them... Look, okay,
stop.
The world
pause. Stop, Pesto. Pause. Put that shit away.
Pause.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay, first of all, I don't think one person should be tasked with creating the ideas for the future. But with someone like
Pesto, put it away.
With someone like myself or my community, who actually engages in trying to bring about real world solutions to these issues, either through like direct action or holding different forums or holding panel talks or things like that. I don't really know more what you could want. I mean, being an armchair futurist only does so much. You have to actually, if you're talking about actually getting out and changing the world, I feel like, debunking mainstream media myths is a good way of doing it. But I also feel like, and this isn't for everyone, but getting out and actually doing organizing is another way you can do it.
So Pesto, what would you say to the idea that just because Jackson doesn't have this like all-encompassing vision, doesn't mean he can be incriminated? What if it's just like knocking on an open door and he's open to all these ideas? Like, what if you're basically making assumptions that he's just ambiguous? You know,
I'm treating Jackson the same way that I treat Julian Assange. I guess he's going out. He's telling people what isn't true. He's not telling them what the higher truth is that people need to understand in order to actually change their way of thinking and contribute to it instead of just knowing something about the struggle,
right.
Contributing to it by understanding these things. The reason why China right now is the center of this future that's being built.
Hey, Pesto.
China has adopted a different vision.
Pesto, shut the fuck up. Ooh, yeah. My fucking nose is bleeding, dude. We got to wrap this up. So we're gonna wrap it up now. And
the world language is gonna
shut the fuck up.
Everything.
No last comments. Words. Last comments, Pesto. You seem like a nice dude, and I hear what you're saying. I think you should maybe look at my, if you're truly concerned, which I don't know if you are, about my content, maybe look at it a bit more and see what I actually do. But I agree with you, but you've also kind of equally said nothing the entire time we've been talking. All right,
we are going to vote. 2 minutes of voting. God damn it. We're going to do 2 minutes of voting, guys. Mods, I want you to, I'm going to spam it once because I could only do it once. Mods, spam this link. Keep spamming it. 2 minutes of voting in chat. For the love of fucking God. If you want this show to be taken seriously, vote based on who you think did the best, not who made you laugh the most. You fucking dumbass chat. All right, I'll be right back.
Vote on who was most truthful. Vote on who was most truthful. Don't listen to him. He can't control you. He's not there with you. Jury nullification. I call for jury nullification. I'm not allowed to do that in court. I'm allowed to do it here.
All right, it's been 2 minutes, and I want to refresh. Oh my God, what a dumbass chat. 161 for Pesto, and 156 for Jackson. You think it's cute, and it, okay, whatever. I don't fuck it up. I guess it's fair. It's fair.
LaRouchePub.com. Go to Sheeler Institute website. Go to LaRouche Organization website.
All right, well, I guess Pesto
I'm sorry. They voted for their conscience, not for what you expected. All right,
shut up. Okay, Jackson, I'm so sorry for this dumbass chat.
You understand that.
It's tragic to be defeated. That's my first loss. It's my only loss I'll ever have, but...
So I voted for you. I hope you know that. I voted for you.
Pesto. You put up a good fight, and you are now the proud owner of the new Infrared Showdown belt. How does that make you feel?
I think next time we're going to do a tournament, because you had it. You won the championship last time. He won it now. We need like a tiebreaker, you know? So next time we're going to do like a tournament, maybe two v2s, and then one v1 at the end. With you,
it's
going
to be at 7. I have to go knitting next week at 7.
So you're not going to be available?
Knitting?
We'll see.
The belt might be taken from you, though. I'll see if
I can change the time with it.
Yeah, the belt might be taken if you do that. Just let you know.
Well, I already have one.
All right, don't bring any props. All right, Jackson, how long are you going to keep streaming?
I'm gonna keep streaming.
You are?
Yeah.
I'm gonna stay live for a little bit longer. I got a nosebleed.
Sounds good.
Substuff I wanted to talk about, but if you're still live, I'll raid you when I'm done.
Okay. I'll catch you guys later.
You better put the links to my websites in the chat like everyone else does.
Pesto, we're not done yet, okay?
Okay.
All right, Jackson. As usual.
Don't want to miss me.
You're great. I personally think you should have won, but... You know, I don't get to decide. I'm just the moderator. But
hey, it's audience decision. Pesto had the better audience opinion. So I'll catch you guys later. Pesto was good talking.
All right, bye bye, Jackson.
The same. Right. I hope we talk again. Love you both.
All right, Pesto vibe, you motherfucker. Has anyone ever told you look like Robert Pattinson?
No. People come up to me and they start speaking other languages to me because they think I look like a Russian or an Irish person.
There you go.
All right.
Here's your belt.
Wow.
I got a nosebleed, so bear with me.
I earned it.
There you go. It's your belt. See? Happy?
Okay.
I might
be coming to Detroit, maybe, in the next month. So I can go pick it up then.
Okay. I don't know if that's going to happen.
We're going to collab stream.
I really don't know if that's going to happen.
Wayne State.
Honestly. But Pesto.
Wayne State with us.
So you won.
Yeah.
You're currently the Infrared Showdown champion.
Yeah.
And so how do you feel?
I don't feel vindicated by this, because I was already vindicated by a higher sense of reality and truth that I learned, and vindicated me because I read it on the LaRouche websites, and I went to the LaRouche Zoom calls, and I went to the in-person LaRouche events.
Okay, and
Through that, I was vindicated. And then later, I just go and I vindicate other people. I'm not the one who got proven right. You guys all got proven right for believing what I told you.
Okay, and so you don't really look too happy about winning, honestly.
I already celebrated my win before I came on the show.
All right, and so I'm assuming RTSG is behind this victory?
RTSG is on top. And RTSG is kind of behind, like, everything when it comes to you, Haas.
I see. And so, okay, and you know what? I might actually bring you. I might actually, like, have Destiny debate you or something. I might bring you on Zerka. I'll see what Zerka thinks. Yeah, maybe you got some potential, Pesto. Maybe you got some potential. But you know, when I told you to bring more right wingers and you brought a fucking anarcho lib, it's like
he said he was libertarian. I just assumed that meant right wing.
Oh my god. Okay.
I asked, "Are you a libertarian?" He said, "Yeah."
Yeah, still, you know. Okay. You know, Pesto. Maybe. All right, listen. How old are you?
22.
All right, listen, kid. You may be going places, kid. You may be going places. Okay, we'll see. We'll see. You maybe got a future ahead. Yeah, keep debating people on Twitch.
Debate all Destiny. Your fans have to tweet this because I won.
Debate. You got to debate Destiny. Debate Vaush. Debate Dylan. Would you debate Dylan Burns?
Dylan Burns? Sure. I'll debate everyone because I know I'm right.
Okay. All right. Well, Pesto, unfortunately, you are the winner. You're not streaming now, so I can't host you. So, what do you want? You want the Hero of Infrared role or something?
Yeah, you have to give me the moderator and Hero of Infrared.
No, you're not getting mod. Okay,
stop. Showrunner.
No, you're not getting showrunner either. You could get the Hero of Infrared role. Okay.
All right.
And maybe VIP in chat. I don't know. All right, you'll get the Hero of Infrared. Okay.
And okay, but you have to make the bot spam the links to all three of the websites.
I don't know how to fucking do that, dude. I don't know. I finally have one hand that's free.
Who knows how technology works? Do it. I don't know how to do it. I don't stream on Twitch.
Dude, you're so fucking annoying. I swear to God.
I won. I
don't even know if it's allowed on Twitch. Today. Okay. Fine, yeah, Neat. Just spam it, Neat. That's what he wants, spam
it. Do you even have the links? It's Schiller Institute, LaRouche Organization.
No, you only get one website. You don't get fucking five websites. You only get one, okay?
LaRouche Pub, then. Actually, no, Schiller Institute.
Okay, fine. Schiller, someone spam the Schiller Institute. Even though it was biased against you, the chat decided to go against me and vote with you. That's great. And people say I run a cult. Some cult this is.
No, it's the opposite. You're going around, you're trying to wake people up, but it's not all the way there yet. Right?
All right, and then keep spamming that link, guys.
There's one part that's missing. Everything's making sense except for some few little things that don't click yet, and then I come on and I make it click.
Okay, and my fucking nose is bleeding.
And they're all my fans now, at least for today, because I won, so I'm in charge of the stream for the day.
No, you're not.
I have the belt. You don't.
You're not in charge of the stream for the day. Okay, I don't know where you're getting that from. But
well, technically, RTSG has been in charge of your stream for like 7 months at this point.
Okay, sure. Any last words?
RTSG is on top. Everyone has to tweet hashtag exonerate LaRouche.
Okay, well, you heard it from him, guys. He said you have to do it because he won. And I don't know. I can't enforce it, but that's what he's saying. All right. All right. Bye, Pestobime. Is that it? Okay. I guess that's it. Oh, okay. Let's go back to the world of sanity.